Stormshield network security, network configuration, bridge mode, or also called transparent mode. Now, just a simple recap in order not to confuse between the network bridge and Stormshield firewall configured in a bridge mode. So it's totally different. Now, network bridge is a very simple device. It works at layer 2. Actually, it splits a LAN into two segments. And these two segments actually, they can communicate each one of them internally, and also they can communicate with the other segments directly through the bridge. But the bridge will store the MAC addresses of both segments, and as a result, it will reduce the traffic. So it sees any packet is going to the other segment, it will allow it to pass based on the destination MAC address. So if segment 1 is communicating with segment 2, the bridge will check the destination MAC address. Based on the list of stored MAC addresses it has, it can tell on which interface it is. So if it's in the different segment, it will simply forward the packet. Otherwise, it will just simply drop it. That means it will reduce the traffic between those two segments. Now, when it comes to Stormshield in bridge mode, it's different. Of course, it shares some of the bridge features, like it works also in layer 2. Not totally. It stores MAC addresses, and also it reduces the traffic. But now, it has more number of ports and segments. So, for example, it's not only limited to two segments. You can have 3, 4, 5, 6, depends on how many interfaces you have in the bridge. Also, in advanced videos, we can also discuss the VLANs as well, that they can be also member of a bridge. So, in just a simple view, just look at the firewall the moment you receive it. For example, it has 6 interfaces, 8, 10, 15, whatever. So, these interfaces, they can all be part of the bridge, and each one of these interfaces can be connected to a different segment. So it can work at layer 2, it can store the MAC addresses of all the segments that are connected to each interface of the firewall, and it will of course reduce the traffic between them the same way that the network bridge works. But this bridge of Stormshield, it also works at layer 3. That means it has an IP address, and this IP address is shared amongst all the interfaces of the bridge. So all the interfaces of the bridge, they have the same IP, and they also have the same MAC address, by the way. Now, the firewall, when it's in bridge mode of Stormshield, it's also having the full functionality, so it's not limited. By default, some different firewalls, when they turn into bridge mode or transparent, they just simply turn into a monitoring device. It's not the case of Stormshield. The case of Stormshield is that it keeps functioning normally. But remember one thing, it's a security device. That means the firewall needs to understand the network traffic flows. It needs to understand everything connected to the firewall, where it should be coming from and where it should be exiting, on which interface to which interface. This is very essential and important. Let's take more examples. So this is the use case of a bridge mode. Now you have a network, and you have your internal network, and also you have a gateway that is connected to the internet. It's actually doing the address translation. So in the internal interface of this firewall, let's say, sorry, this router or firewall, whatever the functionality of it, it has an IP address 192.168.0.1, which is same as the internal network, the LAN subnet that we have. Now, if any one of them is going to the internet, it's going through its default route. So it's going through this router and then to the internet. Now, in the case of a Stormshield in a bridge mode, where you place it in a network that you don't want to change anything in the current setup. So you don't need to change, let's say, the default gateway, the IP address, or whatever. You don't need to change anything. So you just need to place the firewall in a bridge mode between, for example, the default gateway and the local network. So it will be connected on two interfaces in this case. And then you can you need, of course, to provide an IP address to the firewall from the same range. So it will take any IP from the same range. And also you have the option to connect your servers, for example, in DMZ on another interface, which is also part of the bridge. So this is having more segments. So you have your LAN, you have your servers, and you have an interface connected to the router, which is going to the internet. What do you benefit from having the servers and DMZ connected to the firewall directly on one of the interfaces of the bridge is that you can also provide a secure access to the DMZ that you have. So any connection coming from your local network going to the servers, it will pass through the firewall, which means you can have full inspection, full policies, access list, control, authentication, whatever you want to do can also be enforced at this stage. So now, to take a look at the configuration that we have. We have now the internal network. We did not modify the default gateway. We did not modify anything in the subnet that we have. We have also our DMZ connected, and in this example is actually from the same subnet, and still our default gateway is the same, so nothing has changed. So the IP of this gateway is still the same. We just simply implemented the firewall in a bridge mode, connected the interfaces, and we simply gave the firewall an IP from the same range. Now the only thing that matters here is that we should consider the interface here, the one which is connected to the gateway, as external interface. So this we can see in part two where we do this kind of configuration. Now the DMZs and also the servers and DMZs and the internal network, we should put them in interfaces marked as internal, just to tell the firewall that these are our internal networks that we are protecting from the external, which is connected to the internet. Okay, so we have also another point which is very important. Now this is a security device. It's already implemented in a bridge mode or transparent mode. You did not change anything to your network. We just simply changed the cabling, in fact, just to let the traffic pass through the firewall when it's passing from one segment to another. Now let's say that, for example, you have another network connected inside your local network, which is a totally different subnet. So you assume, since it's in a bridge, if I, for example, have any kind of communication going on from this subnet, that it should pass. Now, if you look, if the packet will transfer through the internal router to the local network and then it will reach the firewall interface, the firewall will simply block this kind of connection. Why? Because it will just simply say it's an unknown or like IP address spoofing. This is not only for a bridge, it's in all cases. If the firewall receives a packet that is doesn't know the source IP, it registered all the IP addresses inside the inside network. It registers all the MAC addresses. And now it's receiving an IP that doesn't belong to the IP range of the bridge. And this is a problem for the firewall, so it will just simply raise an alarm, which is an IP address spoofing, because this could be an IP address spoofing attack, or also it could be just wrong configuration. In order to overcome this, so we just simply need to let the firewall understand the network. We need to explain to the firewall that, okay, this interface, it's connected to internal network, but inside this internal network, I have another router here, which has the IP of 0.100. And behind this router, I have another subnet, which is 172.16. And this subnet can communicate through this router, and also it can be communicating through this interface. So how to reach that? It's simply by just placing a static route. So we need to create a static route in that case to tell the firewall that we have this subnet and it's reachable through this gateway. From, you have to give the name of the interface, and this is something we are also going to cover in the next videos. So as a result, what will happen when you will communicate after that? So the firewall will let the packet pass, and also the reply will also, firewall will be able to handle in a stateful firewalling. Very simple. So I hope it's clear. Bridge mode, you can place the firewall in a complex environment. It works at layer 2 and layer 3. It needs to understand all the network segments. It needs to understand the IP addresses that it's communicating through the firewall. And as a result, you will have a fully functioning firewall without modifying anything on your network, except on the firewall itself. You just need to configure it in the right way to understand the network flow, and you can benefit from all the security functions of Stormshield firewall. Thank you for watching.